The South Sudanese government, through the Ministry of Health, directed the indefinite closure of schools starting Monday 18th in preparation for the extreme heat wave that is expected to last for 2 weeks. The government closed all schools due to the serious health hazards posted to the students. The
Minister of Health also gave us a report that because of this high heat, there are cases of meningitis reported, and there are cases of death due to the children especially because of heat, because of exposure to the heat.
Dear ones, Uganda is currently experiencing extreme heat, and the same heat has led our neighbors in South Sudan to close schools. All schools in South Sudan, they have been closed. This cannot be taken lightly in any way, because it is not far from us.
Currently, countries including Uganda are also experiencing a period of severe heat. Against this background, the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Right Reverend Dr. Samuel Kazima Mugalu, has blamed the current climate change challenges on the government officials. He faulted leaders for the buildings erected in wetlands.
Climate change and its effects is a threat to humanity and everything God has created. This is largely driven by human activities such as deforestation, poor waste management, disruption of swamps for settlement, and other human activities that have far-reaching effects on the ecosystems, affecting our weather patterns, food security, and the livelihoods of millions of people.
Kazimba has announced plans by the church to educate and sensitize masses on environment conservation and dangers of climate change. The event that kicked off on Sunday will run till 22nd March under the theme Celebrating Environmental Protection.
The Church of Uganda has organized different events to foster our conservation efforts. These will eventually enable our congregations in different dioceses and beyond to adequately be sensitized.
We have online preaching through this week, where we have our different leaders preaching on Lunch Hour Fellowship, and the topics they have chosen are on environmental conservation.
Meanwhile, schools from different districts in Ankole and Chigezi sub-regions have joined Vision Group Green Schools Initiative, an initiative targeting to involve over 90,000 learners in activities that will help mitigate the effects of climate change.
It's not only about planting trees, because of course we need them to plant trees. But they also need to look after the soil. We've had issues. Climate change has affected us in so many ways. It has brought about the floods.
As we try to implement, we have sabotage from the community, because the community is already used to a certain way of life. For instance, the bottles, plastics, the porcelain papers, and other materials that affect our environment. So now changing their mindset from what they used to now to the new changes seems to be a big problem.
Sidin Miria Babanga, the head of Special Projects Vision Group, challenged schools to use their platforms and look out for innovative approaches of tackling climate change and cause a positive change in the society.
Under this project, we are trying to reduce the carbon footprint that each of us makes. We are looking out for innovative approaches of tackling climate change. And this we cannot do on our own. We identified schools as an avenue for being able to tackle climate change, which is upon us. The heat that we are all experiencing is part of the effects of climate change.
Under this project, Each of the participating schools will have access to 50 copies of weekend editions, which will publish a special pullout that addresses issues to do with climate change. Relatedly, teachers in Busoga sub-region have promised to embrace the Green Schools initiative. The participating schools from Busoga sub-region are Naminyagwe Muslim SS Wujiri, St. Stephen's SS Wujiri, Wanyange Girls School, Busoga College Muiri, Holy Cross Lakeview SS, Jinja College, Pickington College Muguluka, Luzinga SS Kamuli, St. Peter's SS Namwenda, Iganga SS, and Buhehe High School in Busia.
We want to use these newspapers, the newspapers in our classrooms, to show learners pictures, to get information, to get passages, and teach them a number of things, and get visual also with our learners.
They have also been able to carry out tree planting, which has enabled to curb the climate changes. We have gone as far as sensitizing the community about the disadvantages of deforestation.
We're geared up with the coming again of this year's Green School project. We are going to do more activities to help mitigate the effect of climate change.
The Green School Initiative is a partnership between FAO and Vision Group, funded by the Embassy of Sweden in Uganda. Story compiled by Lucian Oboth, Abdul Karim Sengendo, and Donald Kiria for the news.